It's time for our daily devotion. Daily abiding in Jesus Christ. In the book of John chapter 15 verse 7. If ye abide in me, and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what ye will, and it shall be done unto you. A daily devotional ministry project of Cristuto Genobaga from passages taken from the Holy Scriptures with quotations from the Spirit of Prophecy by Ellen G. White. Daily abiding in Jesus Christ.
June 23, 2020. Romans 12 verses 1 and 2. I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
Quotations from the Spirit of Prophecy. Every morning and evening a lamb of a year old was burned upon the altar, with its appropriate meat offering, thus symbolizing the daily consecration of the nation to Jehovah, and their constant dependence upon the atoning blood of Christ. God expressly directed that every offering presented for the service of the sanctuary should be without blemish, Exodus 12 verse 5. The priests were to examine all animals brought as a sacrifice, and were to reject every one in which a defect was discovered. Only an offering without blemish could be a symbol of his perfect purity, who was to offer himself as a lamb without blemish and without spot. 1 Peter 1 verse 19. The Apostle Paul points to these sacrifices as an illustration of what the followers of Christ are to become. He says, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service, Romans 12 verse 1. We are to give ourselves to the service of God, and we should seek to make the offering as nearly perfect as possible. God will not be pleased with anything less than the best we can offer. Those who love Him with all the heart, will desire to give Him the best service of the life, and they will be constantly seeking to bring every power of their being into harmony with the laws that will promote their ability to do His will. Patriarchs and Prophets, pages 352 to 353. Any habit or practice that would lead into sin, and bring dishonor upon Christ, would better be put away, whatever the sacrifice. That which dishonors God cannot benefit the soul. The blessing of heaven cannot attend any man in violating the eternal principles of right. And one sin cherished is sufficient to work the degradation of the character, and to mislead others. By Ellen White. Desire of Ages, page 439.
Prayer for today. Dear God, our Father in heaven, we humbly approach your sacred presence with awe and reverence because you are our Creator and our loving Father. Our hearts are full of joy and thanksgiving because you have brought us to this world, sustains us with the breath of life, good health, and provides us with our daily physical needs and well-being. Help us to present our body as living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to you. Thank you for answering our prayer, for we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.